Hello everyone, welcome to this video lesson. In this video lesson, we are solving a problem basing on conservation of momentum and the momentum concept itself. Let us identify first of all what is given in the problem. The problem is like this. If momentum of a body is doubled, what is the percentage change in its kinetic energy? So to solve this problem, first of all, we need to know the relation between momentum and kinetic energy. We know kinetic energy is the energy associated by the body that is in the state of motion, moving with a certain velocity. So we know the formula for the kinetic energy as half mv square. But we need to now express this in terms of momentum. So what I will do is, I will multiply this equation with mass and divide with mass. So what happened because of this? Half m square v square in the numerator by m. You know mv is nothing but momentum. So m square v square is nothing but mv whole square, that's nothing but momentum square by mass. So the relation between kinetic energy and the momentum is kinetic energy equal to p square by 2m. You probably already know this relation. Kinetic energy is nothing but equal to p square by 2m. Now let's come to the problem. When the momentum of the body is doubled, being body's mass is kept constant, you can write as mass of a body is constant, I can write kinetic energy is directly proportional to p square. So I can write a formula k1 by k2 equal to p1 by p2 whole square. If the momentum of the body is doubled, if p1 is p, p2 is 2p whole square, p and p can be cancelled. 1 by 2 whole square is nothing but equal to 1 by 4. So k1 by k2 is 1 by 4. That implies by cross multiplying, k2 equal to 4k1. Final kinetic energy is 4 times of initial kinetic energy. But what is asked in the problem is, what is the change in kinetic energy? So change in kinetic energy is, kinetic energy final minus kinetic energy initial. Kinetic energy final is k2, that's nothing but equal to 4k1, as we have proved. So 4k1 minus k1 is nothing but equal to 3k1. So delta ke by k1 is equal to 3. This is actually called fractional change in kinetic energy. You want the percentage of the fractional change in kinetic energy. That is, whenever you want to convert any number into percentage, you should multiply with 100. That's nothing but equal to 300%. So percentage change in kinetic energy, fractional change in kinetic energy, is nothing but equal to 300%. That's it. Thank you for watching. Keep coming back for more and more video lessons.